Hi everybody, happy Friday. I'm vlogging finally. On time. A little bit early, but I'm gonna have company later, so I have to get this done early. Yeah, so it's my day off. Day two of being off. It's good. I got paid today. I have some bills to pay tomorrow. My kid has a project due. Got a huge project due. I have no ink in my printer. So I don't know what we're gonna do. I guess we're gonna have to get really creative. So. Okay, let's talk about what's been going on. Okay, what's been going on with me is I've been working a lot. We have a new pharmacist who I will work with every Monday because our old one left. He's a guy, and he's very funny, and I like him a lot. He likes to sing and dance, and he's not a stick in the ass. He's very understanding, and he likes to teach. So if I'm doing something correctly, or if I don't know something, he'll just take time out of what he's doing to teach me. And that's cool. I like that. Stick in the ass, I work with him twice a week. Next week I'll be working with him 3 times a week. I'm not looking forward to it. Stick in the ass is a stick in the ass. It's a pain in my ass. But, what can I do, right? I just have to work. I don't know what is it with this old guy. I think I'm, because of him and some customers that happen to be of the older persuasion, I think I'm starting to dislike old people. I was telling my boyfriend this. I think, like, I'm getting put off by the older generation. I don't know. I think maybe they should kind of be put somewhere, like in a home or... I don't know. They just lately have been pissing me off. You know, like, I get unruly customers and... But, like, the older ones are just really mean and just... bitter. Does that happen when you get old? You just hate everything and everyone and everything, and I don't know. That's what it feels like, so. But, I don't know. Other network's been okay. I am very exhausted more and more. I'm eating less and less, and I've been binging purging more and more. Tuesday night was really bad. I worked stick in the ass, and it was just a bad day. Mondays and Tuesdays are really busy, especially Tuesdays. It's stick in the ass is an old guy, and he's been slacking off. I noticed that Mondays are busy too, but Mondays it's more efficient, and then Tuesdays come around and he kind of slows the pace, and he's really mad, and everyone has to kind of tiptoe around him and shit, and I just hate it. And it was such a bad day on Tuesday, I can't tell you. I got late out of work. I got out of work like at 10 something. I was there all day from the morning until the night. You know, I do like 9-hour shifts and with no break. You know, Monday I actually got a break. Let's talk about Monday for a second before I get into stick in the ass. With the new pharmacist, he gave me a break. He actually told me, look, go take a break. Everyone had took their break and went to go eat lunch. Now, naturally, I'm not exactly the lunch eating person. And so I don't mind sometimes. So the guy tells me, oh my God, you haven't taken a break, have you? Aren't you hungry? Like, go eat something, woman. And I'm just like, no, I'm okay. And then he's like, you know, I really would like some Frosties from Wendy's, you know, those chocolate ice cream things. And, like, I really want one of those. Like, let's go and get some Frosties for everybody and let me go buy you lunch. And, oh my God. So, what do I do now? This man is not only buying me dessert, but he's buying me lunch. And so he bought me, like, this chicken sandwich combo thing and Frosties. They didn't have any chocolate. They have vanilla Frosties. So I didn't really particularly want that. I don't want any of it. And so then, you know, I'm not gonna sit there and eat it with him. So we went back to the pharmacy, and I was in the back of the pharmacy just slowly eating this. I ate like half of the sandwich and just a little bit of fries. I didn't want the Frosty at all. Gross. It was not good. When he wasn't looking, I kind of dumped some of it in the sink, and then I just threw the rest away. But yeah, he bought me lunch, and oh God, I felt so icky afterwards. You have no idea. It sucked. But I made it through, and when I got home, I was just really pissed at myself. I worked out so much that night. So Tuesday, I was just really, it was just a bad day. I got out of work at 10 something, and I went to the Pizza Hut. Pizza Hut was closed, and then I ended up like a Little Caesars pizza place, and I just got me this huge pizza and a big 2 liter soda, and I just came home. I was talking to my boyfriend at the time. I think he was really disappointed at the fact that I just was gonna bench a purse. Like, there was just no denying it. I was just like, listen, I'm here. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. You know, it's been a bad day. Like, I can't. Like, it was just so bad. Like, I don't even want to talk about it. That's how bad it is. When I don't want to talk about something, it's because it's just really awful. So, a little binge and purging. I haven't binge and purged. I binge and purged yesterday, I think it was. Yeah, yesterday in the morning or the day before or something. God. And yeah, Thursday. Or was it Wednesday? No, bullshit, Wednesday. Wednesday when I got out of work, I got my kid, I made dinner, and I binge and purged on dinner. I felt really awful afterwards, like really dizzy and sick. And I was just laying in the bed trying to calm down, and God, I was just like really sick of everything that's been going on. Like, I'm just so tired of this eating disorder. I am on my lowest weight this year, and it's like that's not enough, you know. I don't know what is it about this eating disorder. It's just like this constant thing that just like keep going more and more and more, and like until when, you know. Like, I don't, sometimes I feel like I just can't anymore. I don't, like, some days I feel the weight of the eating disorder. I feel all of the side effects. I feel all of the sickness on top of me. And then there are other days where I don't feel anything, and those are the days that scare me, because those are the days that I just want to keep going, you know. And I'm just like, well, I'm just fine. I'm not sick. I'm fine, you know. I'm not underweight, you know. I still have a long ways to go for emaciation, you know. I think I'm okay, and those are the bad days, because those are the days that I feel untouchable, and it's never, you never are. That's the thing about these things, is that you can look fine on the outside, but I mean, if they gave me an X-ray, I'm sure I'd have all kind of things wrong with me. So, but yeah, I've been binging pretty a little bit more than I'd like, and it's frustrating. I have bad stomach cramps, not stomach cramps. I have bad cramps in my ovaries the other day that had me doubled over. I don't know what that was about. But now my stomach's really bloated from the last time I purchased. It's distended. It's not going down. So, today's a bad body image day for sure. Like, I feel like I want to wear the baggiest, like the hugest clothes I can find, which I don't have really. And just like not be seen right now. I'm not in the mood. Bad body image day. But yeah. So my ex calls me at work Wednesday and says that he wants to talk to me because apparently he has no one else he can turn to with this. And I'm just thinking, oh my God, this man has like an STD, or he is stole something, or is about to get fired. I don't know. And so, you know, for him to try to be friendly with me after he cusses me out every other week because my boyfriend is here, it's a little bit weary. So I am out of work on Wednesday. I get out at 2 o'clock, and I'm on my way home. He has to get my kid, so I'm calling him to let him know, look, I'm on my way home. If you want, you could drop her off. We could talk outside for a second. So he actually pops up on me when I'm walking home. I have to get my glasses. These are my new glasses, by the way. They're pink. Oh my God. This is why I need glasses, you see. They're pink inside, and they're purple on the outside, so yeah. But anyways, I had to get these on Wednesday, and he took me to the optometrist to go pick him up. He was just so friendly. So we were talking along the way, and apparently he wants to borrow money from me, which is just shocking to me, because I just got this job. Don't get paid every week. I get paid every 2 weeks, and I have to work a lot to get paid a lot. So, and I have my own bills to pay, and I have my own, you know, I have a kid to take care of. I don't have a babysitter. I don't have mommy and daddy lending me money. I don't have, you know, somebody I can borrow money from. You know, like, it's just me in the wilderness right now, my kid, and for him to ask me for money is just, you know, and the audacity of this man. I mean, he fucking cusses me out all the time, and I'm like Satan to him, and now you want to borrow money from Satan? Really? You want my hot, money, huh? So, I don't know. I told him, listen, I can't tell you yes and I can't tell you no. Because I have my own things to do, I have my own bills to pay, and I come first, you know, if there's no more us, so I don't gotta put him first, but, yeah, he, according to him, he's just really tight on bills, and he wants to borrow money, and then pay me back next month, and that just makes no sense. I don't know, he's not exactly, I mean, what's to say I lend him money, and then he just completely blows up on me again, and sends me to hell, and then never pays me back, and then I'm on $100, and we're back where we started, and so, I feel bad for him, though. I mean, I have it to lend, but I just, like, I feel bad for him. I'm not, like, my sister's like, oh, be mean to him, be a bitch to him, and let him know you're not gonna give him shit, and remind him that why you're not gonna lend him money, and stuff like that. I mean, yes, that would be, like, the normal thing to do, but I'm not exactly passive-aggressive, you know? So, but I don't think I'm gonna lend it to him, because I've seen a lot of things on eBay that I want. I've seen my Halloween costume. I'm gonna order this wig. I'm gonna go as, like, a Japanese schoolgirl. So I have, like, cosplay Japanese costume and, like, the school uniform, which is really cute. And also, like, this cosplay wig that I want to get. And, you know, and I have to get my kids stuff. And plus, I have to get my kids, things for her classroom. I have to donate and all these things. And so I have my own things going on, you know. I have my own little life trying to come together. And so I just, I can't right now. It breaks my heart, but I just can't right now. So I'm going to kindly let him know that I will not be lending him money. So he actually got a laptop, and he wanted me to, I fixed it up for him last night. It's his very first computer. He's not computer savvy. He's not into social sites, Facebook, Twitter. He's not into any of those things. He thinks people that do those things are complete asshole idiots and are a waste of their time. But that's what everyone says before they get one. People say Twitter is a waste of time, and then they get a Twitter and they're like, holy shit, I can't stop tweeting. So, never mind, I gotta update my status. So, yeah, he has a computer. He told me to please get him an email. I put some sites on there. He needs a computer because my kid has a lot of things, tutoring, and a lot of things online that she has to do, and a lot of homework online through the school that she has to do. And so he has to get with the program. So, the computer program, that is. And so, here we go. We're gonna, I set it up for him, and Sunday he's gonna pick it up, and cross her fingers that he doesn't make a Facebook and tries to friend me. Please, God, no. So, I don't want him as my friend on Facebook. I don't think you're supposed to have, I don't think you're supposed to be friends with your ex. I'm not one of those be friends with your ex people. I'm married to a man still legally, because right now divorce is very expensive, and divorce is the next thing I'm gonna save for after my car. And I'm sorry, I don't like to be friends with my exes. If, you know, me and my boyfriend ever break up, tiddaloo, I'm not your friend anymore. So that's about it. What else can I tell you guys? Other than that, I'm okay. I'm trying. I have bad days, depressing days. I was thinking about, I have seen the doctor this month. I was thinking about telling him to up my depression medication. I don't know what he's gonna say. This is a new doctor. He could possibly tell me, hang in there, kid, chin up. Or like Dr. Jerkoff used to say, oh, just go to a concert, go catch a movie, you'll be fine. No, that's not what you say to people with depression. You don't say cheer up. Really, that's all I had to do was catch a movie. Now I'm all cured. Yeah, okay. Maybe I should eat next and then I won't have this eating disorder. No, you don't say stupid shit like that to sick people. They call them mental illnesses for a reason, honey. You're fucked in the head. It's hard, okay? The wiring goes the wrong way, so I don't know. I was thinking about talking with him about that. I don't know. He could possibly tell me no. He could tell me, you know, work through it. He could tell me get back in therapy, which I should. But I don't know. God, I don't know right now. Therapy, now that I'm working, I don't even know when I can. And I don't have a car, which sucks. All the good therapists are far away. I don't want to have a therapist again in that clinic I used to go to. I don't think so. I think I want to, if I do get back into therapy, it has to be a fresh start and somewhere else. There is a clinic that I want to go to, but it is a little bit away. It would be such a trek just to get there. And that alone, for someone who doesn't like to go out and has anxiety and is depressed, that's like going to Mordor right now. Going to Mordor, that's what that feels like. It's long, and I don't have a slew of people behind me pushing me along the way and telling me things, so it's just me. So I think that's it. I'm gonna go. I don't know if I'm gonna eat today. My boyfriend wants me to eat and stuff. I bad body image day today. I really don't want to eat. I may have a soup. I think I will just have the broth. I'm not gonna eat the noodles or anything. I don't know right now. I don't feel like I can eat anything. I think I'm gonna try to get out of this funk. Cheer up a little bit. So I'm just hoping that I can be productive in the eating disordered way today instead of counterproductive. So that's it. I'm gonna go. I hope you all are well. And we're gonna talk again tomorrow, hopefully, even if it's a little short, teeny tiny video. My boyfriend's taking a bath. And that's it. So goodbye, everybody.